Hi everyone, this is Omkar from EduRekha and today I'll be telling you how to install DVWA, which stands for Damn Vulnerable Web Application, on Kali Linux operating system. Let's look at the agenda for today's session. Firstly, I'll be telling you what is the need for this web application, what is the purpose that this application serves. Then I'll be telling you what exactly this web application is and what are the features of this web application. And finally, I'll be showing you how to install DVWA on Kali Linux operating system. So let's start with the first part of this session, that is the need for DVWA. Most of the beginners who start with ethical hacking learn from watching videos, reading blogs, and reading books. But the knowledge you gain from here is limited, and the best way to improve your skills in hacking is by practice. So DVWA is one such platform where you can practice hacking. So the main intention of building this web application was to avail a platform where beginners can come and practice different hacking techniques and different tools. And this application is very beneficial for practicing hacking, especially for beginners who have just started with ethical hacking, who just know the concepts and the tools and want to practice these tools on a web application. Now, the question is, why use DVWA to practice hacking? Why not practice hacking on one of the web applications that already exists on the internet? The reason is, hacking a target without permission is illegal. You cannot do that. You cannot just pick up a random website on the internet and practice hacking on that. If you do that, you might be imprisoned for it. Now, you might be thinking that it says hacking without permission is illegal. So why not just take permission and practice hacking? Well, unfortunately, organizations don't allow hacking for practice. You might think that you'll just go to an organization, talk to someone from the organization, ask for permission so that you can practice hacking on their website. Well, they don't allow you to do this, mainly because they don't want to risk it, because they don't know you. And even if they know you, their data is at risk, because when you're hacking, there are a lot of points where you can unintentionally delete the data, and organizations don't take this risk. And that's why you can use DVWA to practice hacking. So mainly DVWA is used for practicing ethical hacking within the boundaries of the law. So when I say within the boundaries of the law, you're not doing anything illegal. You're not doing anything wrong. So they've built this platform so that you can practice hacking within the boundaries of the law in a legal way. Now let's see what DVWA actually is. DVWA stands for Damn Vulnerable Web Application, and as mentioned in the name, this web application is damn vulnerable. It's got a lot of vulnerabilities. This is an open source web application that is designed to be vulnerable on purpose so that people can run tools and implement different hacking techniques to hack this web application. Now, what are the features of DVWA? Now, let's have a look at the features of this web application. The first feature is it is very easy to install. In the next part, where I'll be showing you how to install DVWA, you'll realize that it's pretty easy to install. The installation will hardly take 5 to 10 minutes. The next feature is that this web application runs on your local server. You don't need to host this web application on a different server, and you don't even require an internet connection to use this web application. The next feature is that this web application has got various vulnerabilities. It has got different vulnerabilities like SQL injection, cross-site scripting, brute force, and many others. So if you use DVWA for practice, you're practicing more than one hacking techniques, and you can also use more than one tools for hacking this web application. And the final feature, and one of the most useful feature that I've found on DVWA, is that it's got different security levels. While you're playing a video game, which I'm sure you have at least once in your lifetime, you have different difficulty levels. You have easy, medium, hard. And depending on how skilled you are in playing the video game, you choose the difficulty level. Similar to that, when it comes to hacking, DVWA provides 4 difficulty levels as of now: easy, medium, hard, and impossible. And depending on what your skill levels are in hacking, you can choose a different security level. Now, this is all about DVWA. Now, let's move on and see how to install DVWA on Kali Linux operating system. The operating system that I've chosen to install DVWA is Kali Linux operating system. The reason I've chosen Kali Linux as the operating system is because this operating system is designed for penetration testing. And if you're practicing hacking using Kali Linux, it's easy because most of the tools are already pre-installed. Next, we'll have to use a database because this web application will require a database because some of the vulnerabilities are database related. So in this installation video, I'll be using MySQL database. And finally, like I told you previously, we'll be running this web application on a local server. And that's why we need to run a server on our system. And for that, I'll be using Apache server. Now let's see how to install DVWA on Kali Linux. This is the home screen of Kali Linux operating system. And the first step to do to install DVWA is to download the files. So for that, I'll open a web browser and I'll type DVWA git because I'll be downloading the files from GitHub. You'll see a lot of links. I'll click on the first link of GitHub where I'll be downloading this web application from. And I'll just copy this URL. Now I'll open a terminal and download DVWA on my local system. Now before starting the download, I'll switch directory to var www and html because for a web application to run, all the files should be present in this particular directory. So first I'll switch to this directory and then I'll use the command git clone and I'll paste the URL that I copied and .git. This is the extension that you have to give. And then I'll hit the enter button. Now we can see that the project or the web application is getting cloned and it is done. Now I'll just run the ls command and see if it's there. Yeah, so you can see that there's a DVWA directory here. Now the next thing you have to do is give this directory all the permissions. To do this, I'll type chmod hyphen capital R, which says to give the permissions to all the files in all the directories. And the permission I'll be giving this directory will be 777 and then the name of the directory. Now you have to set up this web application to run properly. For that, you have to go into this directory DVWA, and under this directory there is another directory called config. I'll just switch to that directory, and here you'll see a file named config.inc.php.dist. This file has got the default values, the default configuration. I'll just create the copy of this file and I'll name it config.inc.php. So keep in mind that the extension should be PHP. The reason for creating a copy of this file is that in future, if you make changes and you mess up something, then you always have a copy of the default values. So I'll just hit the enter button. And now I'll use a nano editor to make changes to this configuration file. Here you can see a lot of different configuration. And the changes I'll be making is in this part. Firstly, I'll be changing the password to pass and the username to user. You can change the username and password to any username and password that you want, but make sure that you use the same username and same password throughout. Now I'll just save this file and exit it. To save, I'll type Ctrl O, and to exit, there will be Ctrl X. Now I'll just clear the screen. The next thing you have to do is configure the database. To configure the database, first I'll start the database service. The command will be service MySQL start. If there are no errors, that means the service is started. Now let's log into MySQL. I'll be choosing the username root. If the username of your super user is something else, then you'll have to use that username. Now I'll just hit the enter button. And because I haven't given any password, I'll click the enter button again. Now to set up the database to use DVWA, the first thing you have to do is create a new user. To create a new user, you'll have to type create user, the name of the user, that is user at the rate 127.0.0.1. I'm giving this IP address because this is the loopback IP address, which means that the web application is running on the local server. And then I'll type identified by, which is to provide a password, and the password will be pass and a semicolon. So remember, this username and the password should be exactly the same as the password and username that we entered in the configuration file of the DVWA web application. Now I'll just hit the enter button. Now the user is created. The next step to do is grant these users all the privileges over the database. For that, you have to type grant all privileges on, the name of the database will be dvwa.star to provide privileges on all the tables and all the contents of that database. 2, and the username is user@127.0.0.1, and then the password identified by pass and a semicolon. Okay, so the database is set up. Now let me just exit this database and clear the screen. So the web application is configured, the database is configured. Now the next thing you have to do is configure the server. Before configuring the server, you'll have to start the server first. So I'll be using the command service apache 2 start, because the server I'm using is apache 2. Now we have configured the web application and also the MySQL database. The next step to do is to configure the server. For this, you'll have to make some changes in the configuration file. So first, I'll switch to the directory where this configuration file is. The directory will be cd etc php 7.3. In some cases, if you have a different version of Apache or different version of PHP, this path might change. So make sure you're in the right path, and then Apache 2. Let's see what files I've got here. So this is the file, the php.ini is the file that I have to make the changes to. I'll use a gedit text editor, and the file name is php.ini. The changes you have to make are these two configurations. The first one is allow URL F open. You have to set this as on. And the second one is allow URL include. You also have to set this to on. In some cases, maybe when it's the first time you're opening this file, you might find that one of these or both of these configurations are set to off. So make sure both of these configurations are set to on. Save the file and exit the file. Next thing to do is to start the service. So the command is service apache to start. Okay, so I've configured the server. Now let's open the browser and access this web application. To do this, I'll type 127.0.0.1 because this is where I'm running the web application on my local server, and the name of the directory, that is dvwa. I'll click the enter button. So when you open this web application for the first time, you'll see a setup page, and you'll see a lot of different information regarding the configuration. So what you have to do is scroll down to this web application and click the create or reset database button. You can see that the database has been created, and you'll see a lot of different information, and you'll be redirected to a login page. The default password and username for this login page is, the username is admin and the password is password. I'll hit enter, and here is the home page of DAM vulnerable web application. There are some general instructions, warnings. And on the left hand side, on this part, you can see there are a lot of vulnerabilities that are present, and you can practice these vulnerabilities. And like I told you about the security levels, if you look at this tab, let me just click this tab, you'll see that there are different security levels: low, medium, high, and impossible. If you want to change it, you can change it like this. You can set it to low and submit, and then choose whichever vulnerability you want to practice, and then run tools or hacking techniques. Well, that's how you can install DVWA on Kali Linux operating system. That's all for this session. If you like this video, like and share, and stay tuned for more videos on ethical hacking. Thank you and bye-bye.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries, and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to EduReka channel to learn more. Happy learning!